My name is Kim Øyhus, and this is my photo e-paper, a system for showing color photos on electronic paper in the highest practical quality, thus making photos good enough on this limited display. As you can see, it is good enough for portraits, which I have not seen anyone else do. This one was taken by photographer Richard Engelstad. So there you have it, color photos on electronic paper in good enough quality for portraits, etc. And here comes the next photo. As you can see, a rather complicated process. The development time for photos on this e-paper is 30 seconds. The technology is electrodiffusion of pigments. Supposedly, there exists color e-paper which uses only 1.5 seconds, called Kaleido, but they are not available, so I am skeptical about those. The model is holding a color checker, so we can check the colors, which are limited but good enough for most photos when optimized by my photo e-paper. You can download optimized photos from its webpage, photo-epaper.com. There is also more information there on how to use it, how to write to the e-paper with Python programs. Electronic paper does not use electricity, except a little bit when changing images, so it is a green technology. An image can last for months without any electricity. This one has been disconnected for about 3 months. As you can see, it has become grayer due to thermal diffusion of pigments. But if it is rewritten once a week, it will look fresh. An e-paper device can run for years on a single battery. My photo e-paper seems to excel in three ways. Firstly, the colors are more accurate. Human skin is skin colored, all shades, making portraits possible, as you can see here. Secondly, less grainy images. As you can see from these smooth shades of yellow on this car, there are some necessary graininess up close, but it fades fast with distance. Grains are minimized. Thirdly, sharpness. As you can see from these sharp lines, backlight, side mirrors, the image is sharp. It looks a little bit sharper than the e-paper itself due to optimization. This e-paper is driven by a Raspberry Pi Zero. It can be driven by something much smaller. It must have an SPI interface and enough memory to hold one photo. Raspberry Pi, SPI interface, and cable to the e-paper. The e-paper itself is quite thin, as you can see. The practical uses for a photo e-paper are more than photos. It can be used to show web pages, like this one from Google, where I searched for art photography in color. As you can see, it works. The text is sharp, and the images too, and their colors are good enough. If one wants to use this for a web pad, the faster Kaleido e-paper might be a better choice if one can get hold of it. A more practical use of photo e-paper is for price tags. Showing photos or products is better marketing. It makes it easier to understand what the product is. It can also be used for ads. Banana, apple, pear, orange. My food shop uses e-paper price tags this big in black and white. The local electronic shop uses price tags this big in black, white, and red. And here come the primary colors of this e-paper. There are 7 of them. It is fascinating to watch. Photo e-paper mixes this palette. As you can see, the colors are dull. Off-white, grayish-black, grayish colors. But these limited colors are not a big problem, as reality is also quite dull. Most photos are dull. And thus, color e-paper works good enough for most photos when optimized by photo e-paper. If one has photos with highlights, deep blacks or brilliant colors, one can still use photo e-paper, which will find the closest colors on the e-paper, and this is often good enough too. This particular e-paper model is ASAP from eink.com. They call it Gallery something. I buy them from Waveshare or Pimarone. This big one has a resolution of 800x480 pixels, but photo e-paper makes it look a little bit sharper. They may be sold out of these big displays, but they have smaller ones too. And there you have it. Color photos on electronic paper in good enough quality. Due to heavy optimization of images by photo e-paper on a server. I hope it can be useful for you.